It's like a mirror, and I'm going to pretend that two people aren't behind me right now. Out of view. We're about to record episode 128, and the song is Velvet Elvis by Alex Winston, who's becoming one of my favorite singer-songwriters. I can see you, Nan. Thank you guys so much for nominating us for the podcast awards. Continue to do it if you haven't nominated us yet. Why are my crazy, like, baby hands down here? If you haven't done it yet, there's still time to nominate us, and we'd really appreciate you nominating us. And we're just waiting for Danielle to get here. But in the meantime, we'll answer some questions. Okay, I'm gonna hit the red button. Brian, do you have a confession?
A confession?
What's in that glass?
That is mostly orange juice.
Mostly. What's the other percentage?
Ice.
And?
Sky Vodka by USA.
And was that in your console while you were driving?
That might have been in my cup holder while I was driving.
And I'm going to flip it around. That reminds me, one time when I was with my mother, I was drinking with my mother, and I had a little bit of wine left over, and she said, do you want me to put in a cup for you to go take it out? And I said, no, mother, that'd be illegal.
It might be illegal.
But it's cost effective.
It is, and, you know, when you're really hungover, sometimes you just need to take the edge off.
And it's Texas. We run by our own rules here.
That's true.
Exactly. Nan knows this.
I'm not going to vomit on my breast.
Sunday's Mimosas Day. Mimosas? Miss Osmosis? Mimosa?
No. You're blackmailing this video.
Mm-hmm. What about Al-Anon now, bitch? And you're just holding it like a lady. If only I could put a boop sign, like as if you just pulled it out of your crotch.
There you go.
Oh, I've got a question for Brian. Brian, have you ever been watching a threesome video, pornographic film?
Yes.
And then all of a sudden, no, but then all of a sudden it turns into a double penetration film, and you're like, whoa, I did not sign up for this.
Isn't that most threesome videos?
Well, depends on your definition of double penetration.
Yeah, I guess that's true. So we were having this conversation once.
Right. If it's like top and bottom, that's
okay. I think that's double tip penetration.
But that's not what's considered. Like one in the boot and one in the coot?
As clearly as one in the...
As two in the coot.
Like that's true
double.
Right.
But two in the coot?
So what were
you... I have not like really ever seen that.
What were you talking about?
Most DP is one in the vagina and one in the booty hole.
Yeah.
So you were talking about top and bottom.
I was talking about, like upstairs and downstairs, top bunk and bottom.
And that bothers you?
Yeah, it's just weird.
Are we talking MMF threesome? Well, I don't know.
How can he do bunk beds if there are two women and one man?
Well, actually, I mean, one chick could eat one chick out while the guy banged her from behind.
That just seems dangerous.
I've seen that.
It seems like they would be distracted.
It seems like the woman that's eating her out could get a bloody lip.
Today's question comes from Kyle. It was for me. And it says, I have a question for your advice segment on Secretly Timid's YouTube vids. It's a nice plug right there at the beginning from Kyle. So he says he has a history of mental health issues, anxiety, depression, bouts of suicide, and severe confidence problem. And last year, I'm just gonna read it in Kyle's words. Last year I came the closest I've been to committing suicide. Luckily my partner had referred me to a therapist colleague of his, and I was able to call her for help, and she got me into see a psychiatrist, and I'm now doing much better on meds and talk therapy. Yay. Sorry for that lengthy explanation, My question is that several friends have expressed concern for my absence from the scene and have been respectful in letting me come up with vague explanations. What advice would you give as far as if, how do I discuss my struggles and experiences in a way that isn't TMI or wouldn't make them feel disappointed that I didn't ask them for help?
Hugs.
All right. Well, first off, I'm glad that you're getting talk therapy as well as medication, because I'm a big fan. I'm not a big fan of just getting medication and not seeking talk therapy, so that's good. As far as like sharing your experiences with others, Brian could actually attest to the fact that I don't know from TMI. Like, there's no such thing for me. One of the things that I have found actually is that sharing as much as I'm comfortable sharing with my friends, kind of takes all the power out of whatever problems I'm facing and helps me to realize that a lot of people feel the same way that I do. And as for your friends feeling disappointed that you didn't come to them for help, a lot of people understand that some things are better handled by a professional, and if they don't, that's kind of more their problem than your problem. So I know that people who have anxiety and depression tend to take on the feelings of others and feel guilty for things that really aren't their fault. You didn't do anything wrong. You didn't hurt anybody. You didn't set out to hurt those people. So if they're bothered by it, give them your therapist's number. And I guess that's my answer to your question. Hugs.
Danielle's here.
Serious?
Danielle, I thought of somebody else you look like.
Who? I've been trying to figure out my celebrity doppelganger forever, and everyone tells me it's Jennifer Love Hewitt, but I disagree.
Oh, I can see that.
Oh,
yeah, I can see that
I'll
too.
Go for that one. I like her name.
Who's that?
And
Charlotte Gainsbourg?
Yeah.
Serge Gainsbourg's daughter.
There's the,
She's in...
Oh, I opened the wrong scene. Secretly too.
The Silent Hill movie? The little girl in Silent Hill.
The original Silent Hill?
Yes. She's 18 now.
I'll have to look her up. Like, you know, they're going to have a
sequel?
One now.
Yeah, that's what I bought
that
it.
That movie scared the shit out of me.
I thought you'd like it, the nurses.
No, I loved it, but I had so
it's all
many
choreographed.
Nightmares about these, like, nurses.
That movie was pretty freaky.
Mm-hmm.
I liked it. I thought it was really pretty.
That was my shoulder that just popped.
Last night I had a terrible nightmare. And my husband's out of town, and I fell asleep on the couch. And at like 2 a.m., I heard somebody in the house whisper in my dream, 666 is the number of the beast. And then I woke up, and I could not go back to sleep for hours. It was terrible. It was like, oh, and in my dream, at the time when that happened, I was like searching the house for pornography, and I could not find any. And then somebody went, 666 is the number of the beast. Yeah.
Why would you open your house?
I don't know.
Wait, what are they looking at?
Go to our Facebook page.
I am on our Facebook page.
Scroll to where I said, hey, we need questions. And then
so far we have one question.
Lala Siegfried answered. Yeah.
Okay.
In the comment post.
You want to answer this question?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
the second part of the question, not the first. The first part's a joke. It was just
a joke. Okay. Oh, well, what's the second part of the question? My question, this is actually, blah, 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 blah. So your friend is dating this guy and she will not shut up about it. I get it, you're in love or whatever, but how do I let her know I'm happy for her, but I don't want to hear every fucking detail without sounding like a, oh, that's what that means.
A see you next Tuesday.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, what is that word? Clever. So how do you tell your friend to shut up about her?
I don't think, I'm going to try to answer this one.
Oh, you're good.
I don't think you should necessarily shut up. I think you should just develop ways of not listening to her, but making it sound like you are.
I like that
like,
answer.
Go to another place in your mind, and then just randomly say,
and try
like, you have a point there. Oh, I know what you're saying.
Well, and try to think of a time when you were obnoxiously in love with somebody and telling everybody, because everyone does that. You know.
Yeah. You could also at some point like make a joke, a jokey way of saying you're doing it again, you're going on and on about your...
Or...
Oh, I always tell people that I feel vomit rising in my throat. I'm like, oh, I'm gonna vomit right now if I have to hear this again. And then I go, ha 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 ha.
Or.
But seriously.
And I apologize for the camera work, but you need to actually get a camera soon. And not
I
an
have,
iPad.
I have like a camera that does video as well, and it's pretty decent. Cool. We use it to shoot some of it.
No, I was thinking, or you could play some mental judo and start asking a lot of questions. To the point where she's not doesn't want to talk to me anymore. Like really inappropriate questions.
You should just say if you like him so much, why aren't you over there talking to him right now?
Oh yeah, there's that.
All right, so thank you for sending us questions. If you want to send us more questions, we have some mimosas.
Our answers didn't completely suck.
And some microphones, and we're gonna get into recording episode 128. Come on, Brad.
I said Brian. I just said it really quickly.
She said it really
and succinctly. Brad?
Okay,
I
so
don't
we're.
I have an accent.
We are done with episode 128. We're calling Jalapeño Seed, right?
Yeah, and you'll have to listen to find out why.
That's what you're calling it?
Oh. Hurts me to think about it.
Some of us here might have had a lot of alcohol. Which is why. You can point at me too. That's why it's a little unsteady right now, and why Nan had to take over reading duties.
I was just gonna start moving with the camera.
So, what we talk about today?
Literally don't remember.
Lots of talk about peeing.
Peeing.
John apparently
sandwiches.
Has some interesting ideas about ladies.
Yeah, that John does not know how female anatomy works at all.
I'm gonna take him to the bathroom and show him my vagina.
Without jalapenos. Sandwiches and cats and
abortions. And yeah. Scientology.
So just normal stuff.
Yeah, the huge.
And keep it coming, guys. If you ever have any questions or need advice, email us at letters@secretlytimid.com and we will answer them on the next video. Bye.